Honey and Frank Show, comedian Bobby Lee is going to be performing at the Irvine Improv today through Sunday. For tickets, go to irvine.improv.com, at Bobby Lee Live on Twitter. Where is Bobby? Get him in here. I always love having Bobby on the show. There he is.
All right,
what?
Man.
What? You're so cute.
Oh, thank you so much.
Comedic genius.
You called me a comedic genius on the air. That's really nice.
Yeah.
I'm really not.
You're not?
No, I'm really dumb.
But don't you think?
I really am. I got like C's in high school, but to like Asians, that's F's.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I got
that's
beat.
That's
down.
Not average for Asians.
No, it's not average at all, no.
Especially you got one of those tiger moms.
Yeah.
And then they go after you, you know? It's not fun.
So, how you been, man? What you been up to?
Oh, man, things are great. I'm nothing. Nothing's happened.
I thought you were shooting some big pilot television show.
I am. I got a pilot.
You got
this
a pilot?
Something.
Unfortunately, it
I'm
was
really
Harrison
excited.
Ford.
What?
Comedic
that's
genius.
Too soon.
Is it too soon?
A little bit.
He's not dead. Okay.
Yeah. No, he's fine.
He's fine.
Yeah.
Broke his leg.
Yeah. Oh, happy birthday to Grace Park.
Who's that?
You said happy birthday to the lady from Hawaii 5-0.
Oh, yeah.
She's 41.
She looks great.
She looks amazing. I had no
Asians?
Idea she was 41.
How old are you? 60?
I'm 86. 60,
yeah, yeah.
I'm 86. I was in the original Karate Kid movies. Remember? Wax
yes.
on, wax off.
Oh,
I did that. It was
yeah,
me.
Yeah, Mr. Miyagi.
Yeah, Mr. Miyagi. And
good.
No, but happy birthday to Grace.
Is that a phenomenon that happens to Asian women where they hit a certain age and all of a sudden they become old Asian women?
Well, yeah, they turn into mythological creatures.
What is that about?
Yeah. She's going to look like Gollum at 62.
I mean, she's hot now.
Yeah.
Did I see
I'm going to look like Yoda.
Did I see you on a trailer for The Comedians, The Billy Crystal Show?
Was I in it?
I think so.
I was in it, yeah.
Now,
yeah.
When I saw it, I thought, is this show where there's some people aren't actors and some people are?
No, I played just an Asian dude with an accent.
Okay.
Was that hard for you to do?
It was very difficult for me to do, yeah.
Did you
yeah.
have to audition?
They go, do it more Asian. I go, oh, like these? And they go, more. And they go, that's
oh,
perfect.
Yeah, perfect.
Like that's really good. It's really good. No, I got to work with Billy Crystal. I was really excited.
That's awesome.
I was scared.
Yeah, why?
Because, you know, you hear people go, oh, you know, he's weird or whatever. But then I showed up and he was so nice to me.
Did
he smiled at me, he touched me and stuff. It was crazy.
Do you think he heard that you're kind of weird?
I am very weird.
Yeah.
He was probably scared.
Probably
I'm
Bobby
shaped like
Lee.
A scallop, you know what I mean? I'm really ugly. Am I ugly?
No, Bobby Lee. I don't know why you say that about yourself.
I look like Pikachu with diabetes or something. You know what I mean? Like, I just don't feel good.
But you put all this on Tinder.
Yeah, I do. I really do.
How you doing with that? Because I know the last time we talked to you, you actually met a girl.
She's in the car.
Well, you
right now,
in
the
car.
No, she didn't want to come in.
Why not?
She's tired.
Well, so am I, but I came in.
I know.
I'm here.
But she's in the car right now. Hi, Kalila.
So it's been over a year now.
Over a year now, yeah.
And you met her on Tinder.
I met
you
her on Tinder, and it's really working.
That's so crazy.
Yeah.
Did you expect to find a girlfriend on Tinder?
No. You know what I mean? I just want to have some fun. You know what I'm saying? And then, like, the first two were nightmare dates. Like, the first one was, you know, first of all, there's some rules. Number one, all the photos have to be from the whole body. It can't be just from shoulders up.
Oh, okay.
Because I picked a girl, and I'm sorry.
That's okay.
And I picked her up, and she looked like Natalie Portman, but her body was like Michael Chiklis.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And then, she was walking down the stairs, and I wanted to drive, but we eye contact.
Mm.
So I took her on a date.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure she's great. She's a great person. I'm sure she's great.
Now, let me ask you. What's your girl's name in the car?
Kalila.
Kalila?
Yes.
All right, Kalila. Turn it down real quick because I need to ask a question.
Oh, yeah, she's fine.
All right.
Ask me.
Is your Tinder account still active?
No. And she caught me with it like six months ago. It was still there.
You were still checking
it. Because I was having funsies with it.
Meaning you just wanted to see how many connections you could
make. The matches make you feel good.
Yeah, it's an ego boost.
Right?
Okay,
and then you look at the profile pictures and then you take a bath.
Right.
You visualize. You know, I'm like, you know what I mean? And then you move on. But then she saw it, and then she got really mad, and then I took it off.
Well, she met you on Tinder. Did she shut down her account as well?
She did immediately. I did in 6 months.
It took you 6 months.
Yeah, it took me 6 months. It's a fun game.
I think that if you are in a relationship, I think that you should be allowed to actually get on Tinder as a couple and then sit there on the couch. You're not just for ego boost alone to say, hey, look what I could have got tonight.
Right.
But we're gonna stay home and watch Netflix.
No woman's falling for that, and Kalila knows it. She's like, no, we're done. We got the match.
You're a genius.
Dating,
you really are.
Emotional genius.
Yeah.
Actually, no, I'm horrible at that. As far as a relationship goes, are you a good boyfriend?
I don't cheat. I've never cheated in my life.
Are you sensitive?
I mean, I have. I mean, I go through like.
Yeah, but there's. Do you have weird definitions of cheating? Like he's like, oh, if you're on the road, and like you make out with a girl, but you don't have sex with her. That's cheating. You know that, right?
I even think strip clubs is cheating.
How about a massage parlor with an HJ?
I mean, what's HJ? Oh, yeah. I saw the visual, yes.
Is that cheating?
Yeah, that is cheating.
She's a professional.
I know.
But you got to stop her when she goes to that area and you're like, no.
What if I carry all my stress in my prostate?
You know what I've been doing is I have. I got that joke. I'm not even doing it to myself right now.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm like trying
you
to
save
like build
it for
up.
Her.
I'm trying to save it, yeah.
Because it does make things better.
Because you feel like you're cheating on her if you do it by yourself?
What?
You feel like you're cheating on her if you do it with
yourself? No, I just want to be more sexually vigorous. Is that a word even?
Right, like virile.
Viral. I want to be more viral. I want to be more sexually viral.
Good sex goals, being viral.
I want to explode. Like, remember the end of, like, Ghostbusters? Right. When the marshmallow man exploded? I want to be that guy.
Right. I get that. Saving it up
it's a
for
mess. It's
Bobby
a mess.
Lee hanging out with us. Bobby Lee's going to be performing at the Irvine Improv today through Sunday. You can get your tickets at irvine.improv.com. Do you have any community property with Kalilah?
What does that mean?
You live together?
Like you bought something?
No, she lives
in.
At my house. She lives at my house.
Did you buy something together? Like, or maybe you did you get an animal together?
We have two animals, two cats.
Okay.
First of all, can I say this? I hated animals until I met her. She opened my world to animals.
See,
I used to run over kittens on the road.
Really?
Yeah.
Bobby.
And think about eating them, like sashimi. Sashimi. Yeah. You know what I mean? But like now I have two cats and I don't want to eat them at all.
No. Oh, wow.
I pet them and everything.
Yeah. Why did you hate animals to begin with?
I never grew up with them and I just hated them. Because the thing is that I eat them.
Did you ever have a bad experience?
They're delicious.
A bad experience with a wild animal? Ever like get approached by a wild animal?
Oh, no, what do you mean?
Like you're out there picking out the trash and there's a possum in your backyard. You're like, oh my God, that thing is scary. And it goes... You never had experience.
He just sees dinner. I don't and he's ever just go like,
outside.
Oh,
yeah. I go yum.
What's the strangest thing?
I'll eat that.
What's the strangest thing you've ever eaten? That might blow our minds.
I ate balut.
You did eat balut.
Yeah, you know what that is?
Yes.
Yeah, it's delicious. Like, it's like baby duck.
It's a baby
but
duck,
but that's still in the thing, in the egg.
It's still in the egg. Yeah. Is it true that you like?
It's crunchy.
It's crunchy.
Is the shell? Part of it, you eat the whole shell.
It's like a soft shell crab. Have you ever had a soft shell crab?
Yeah, but I hate soft shell crab.
Yeah, but that's what it's like.
But you take the meat out of the shell, right? Or you just eat the whole
thing? No, you don't eat the shell, but you eat the meat part. Yeah.
And it looks like
I
a bird.
Just like wait 2 weeks, you know, eat the baby.
I don't know. What is it when it's a baby? Somehow
that's being
it seems
impatient
more,
almost.
It's like
know?
A real live peep.
And it's and it's alive, right?
No, it's not alive. No, it's dead. It's pretty much dead.
It's not born yet.
Well, I know
it hasn't hatched.
But if it was still in the nest under its mom, it's alive. If they let it go 2 weeks, it would hatch.
Yeah, but I think they ferment. Is that the word, ferment?
Yeah, they save them for
a
while.
Yeah. They soak it in something.
If they're fermented, you can actually get a buzz off eating balut?
Maybe.
I'd have to have a buzz to even consider eating it.
Can you imagine getting drunk on that? Yeah.
Imagine if it was alive, that'd be weird, right? If it went quack, and then you're like, oh, I'm going to eat you anyway. You know, that'd be weird, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I like this kid right here. How old are you, 12? I mean, Jesus.
Same goes for you. You look super young too.
Oh, thank you so
much.
That's
why I think he might be part Asian, Eric, because he does have
a
very
looks so young. How old are you?
32.
Oh my God, you look amazing for a white dude. Unbelievable.
Yeah, for a white dude, yes.
Yeah.
How old do you think I am?
You're 24.
Thank you.
No, I'll be real. You're 39.
I'm 44.
You look great.
For a white dude.
For a white dude, you look great.
For a white dude.
How old do you think she is? This ought to be
you.
This ought to be good.
Look at me. Hide at me. Look at me right now. I'll be real. 29. And that's a fact.
Come here.
And that's truth.
I'm going to pleasure you right now.
But you're not into that.
I'm going to pleasure you. No, I'm good at it, though.
I know. You're very good.
Show him your tongue. Show him your tongue.
He's seen it.
Yeah, you've seen it?
Yeah, that's
why he came back.
That's how we lured Bobby Lee back.
So you were up late last night, right?
Yeah, I'm doing a pilot called Problem Child on NBC.
Are you the child?
No.
I'm just asking questions.
No. It's based on the movie.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So they're doing a TV version of it. So I got a cast. I'm excited.
And you are the star.
What?
Are you the star?
No, I'm like fifth lead.
Okay.
Which is
so
what I
like
want.
Like a goofball neighbor?
Like the neighbor guy, yeah.
Is it an Asian-based show?
No.
It's not on?
No, why? Why do this have to? I'm an American.
Well, I know there's that.
I mean, can I ask you this?
Okay, ask me.
Right,
this.
Is Entourage an Asian-based show? There's an Asian. Is Grey's Anatomy an Asian-based show? There's an Asian in it. Frank, think about what you're saying when you say it.
I was trying to say there's that new show called Boat People. on Fox or something,
fresh
right?
Off the boat.
Oh yeah, fresh off the boat.
And I was thinking, call it Ching Chong. There's a new show called Ching Chong, and no,
I thought
I can say that because I am Asian.
Yeah,
it's
right.
a successful
right.
show. Maybe they're going with other Asian-centric shows.
No, I think they're casting more Asians. Maybe I don't know.
Yeah,
yeah, but you know, it was the same
a good thing. Did you? By the way, did you cast an Asian?
What do you mean?
Is Kalila Asian?
She's a jungle Asian. Can I say that? She's Filipino. Is that
that's
not?
Jungle Asian? I've never heard that before.
Jungle Asian. That's a little edgy. I shouldn't say that. No, she's a Filipino.
That's where you ate the blue. You went back to meet her family?
Yes. I went to Philippines.
And you had to do that because you were like...
No, I want to be a part of the culture.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're going to marry this girl, aren't you?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
She can peel a mango with her feet. It's amazing. The dexterity in those things.
Well, that must come in handy in the bedroom. Yeah. Well, boy, that girl can pick.
And she has a machete. It's amazing.
Bobby Lee, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you. I love you so much for promoting me. And I love you guys. And I want to come back one day next year, okay?
Yeah,
one day next year.
Yeah, come back next year. We'll see how everything's going.
LegalZoom.
Irvine Improv.
Do the LegalZoom thing.
Today through Sunday, get your tickets, irvine.improv.com. And be sure and follow Bobby on Twitter, at Bobby Lee Live.
I love you guys so much.
Right. I love you, too.
We're going to come right back. We're Heidi and Frank.
The Heidi and Frank Show. Mornings on 95.5 KLOS. LA's number one talk show in the morning. On air and online at HeidiandFrank.com.